In the previous video, I gave an overview of the electron transport chain and described how complex 1 moves electrons from NADH to coenzyme Q while pumping protons out of the matrix. In this video, I will explain how complex 3 takes electrons from coenzyme Q and transfers them to cytochrome C. Complex 3 is also called the cytochrome BC1 complex because 2 of its subunits are cytochrome B and cytochrome C1. The reaction it catalyzes is represented in this diagram. 2 electrons from QH2 are transferred to cytochrome C, which you may remember is a peripheral membrane protein associated with the inner mitochondrial membrane. As this happens, 2 protons are removed from the matrix, and 4 protons are released into the intermembrane space. The net reaction is shown here. QH2 is oxidized, and 2 cytochrome Cs are reduced. This representation is a simplification of what happens, which is a process called the Q cycle. Let's look in a little more detail at what happens at complex 3. Now here I've represented complex 3 with this gray shape. Complex 3 has 2 binding sites for coenzyme Q. One site near the intermembrane space has a higher affinity for the reduced form of coenzyme Q, and the other site near the matrix has a higher affinity for the oxidized form. Also in complex 3 are 3 heme groups and an iron sulfur center. Within the inner mitochondrial membrane, at any given moment, there will be a mixture of oxidized and reduced coenzyme Q. 3 molecules of coenzyme Q are involved in the Q cycle. We'll need 2 reduced Qs and 1 oxidized Q. Note also that I'm showing 2 protons on the matrix side of the membrane. In the first step of the Q cycle, 2 molecules of coenzyme Q bind to complex 3 according to the binding preferences of the binding sites. The reduced coenzyme Q loses a single electron to form a free radical semiquinone. As it does so, it loses 2 protons, which are released into the intermembrane space. The electron is transferred to the iron sulfur center, and then to cytochrome C1, and then to cytochrome C, which becomes reduced. The semiquinone loses its remaining electron, but the second electron follows a different path through complex 3. It is transferred to the so-called heme BL, then to heme BH, and then to the coenzyme Q bound at the other site. This forms a semiquinone at that site. We're now at the halfway point of the Q cycle. Remember that this site at the bottom has a higher affinity for a reduced coenzyme Q, so the oxidized Q at this site dissociates from the complex and is replaced by a reduced Q. This new QH2 will lose its electrons just the same way the first one did. Upon loss of an electron, 2 more protons are moved into the intermembrane space. The electron goes from Q to the iron sulfur center, to heme C1, and then to a second cytochrome C, which is reduced. The second electron is lost, going to heme BL, then to heme BH, and then to the semiquinone waiting in the other binding site. At this point, this Q gains 2 protons from the matrix to become QH2. Now both coenzyme Q molecules don't match the binding preference of the 2 sites, and they will dissociate from the complex. So if you remember what the diagram looked like at the beginning, you'll see the 2 QH2s have been converted to 2 Qs, and 1 Q has been converted to a QH2. 2 protons have been removed from the matrix, and 4 protons have been added to the intermembrane space, and 2 cytochrome Cs have been reduced. This will give you the net reaction shown here. The 2 reduced cytochrome Cs leave complex 3 to find complex 4. Now this figure from the textbook shows the 2 halves of the Q cycle. In the next video, I'll move on to look at complex 4 and I'll summarize the electron transport chain from NADH to oxygen.